So good morning, student. I hope all of you are fine. We are going to take unit number 5, Programming the Computer. Lesson number 1, Introduction to Program. We'll take 2 lessons, 1 and 2 together. How can we introduce our program? What is a programming? And there are some algorithms and flowchart, what they are. Maybe some of you already know what is the program. If you don't know, a computer program instruction is stored as a file on a hard drive. When you run the program, list of commands or instruction is read by the computer. Then the computer does what the program tell it to do. There is a program beside the computer. Like we already know the difference between what is hardware and software, right? So the computer and its program make electronic useful. The program of computer make it useful so we can we can send, we can receive, we can create something on our computer. So all this is what, this is all here a program, programming. All programming help us to do, store files, store our data into our hard drive. Next thing. How do people write program and how can someone write a drawing program for a game? For example, how you are playing the game, how you can using some online websites, there is a program beside it. Now, when you play a game, you are just see there are some animated people. They are running or they are collecting some stuff. They are building the house, different type of games. Yeah, but it is not actually a people or someone, it is actually who is beside it, the program. Now, as you know, what is a program? Program is a list of instructions. Instructions means the guidance that we store in a file or our hard drive inside our computer. So when the program is written by a programmer, for example, I am a programmer, okay? Everybody is not a programmer. It's only the professional people, they can be a programmer. So let's suppose if I am a programmer, I create a game or I write a program of game for you. So it is impossible to write the program in 0 and 1. 0 and 1 is what? 0 and 1 is a language of computer, which we cannot understand it. What?
Page what?
Page number 86. Page number 86. So 0 and 1 is a language of computer. We call it binary language. Computer don't understand English, Arabic, Italian, French, any language. Computer understand only 0 and 1. So we don't know what is 0 and 1 language. It is very hard. For example, we want to write the word, as you can see here in the example, take the user input. How if, what if we write this in zeros and 1? We don't know letter T is what? Letter T is 0 and 1, or how can we code them, right? It's hard for us to understand. So the programmer, when the programmer is write any program, it is impossible for him also to write it in 0 and 1, which is the language of computer. So programmer write in a program language. There is a language of program, the code language. They use some codes. Once the program is written, the programmer used to turn this instruction into the correct 0 and 1s. For example, here is an example of one program that take the user input, word, raw input, enter some text, translate, pig, Latin. He is writing a program now. We don't know what this means, why he is putting equal, bracket, percentage, different mark. Why? Because it is a program language. This is a furthermore studies. If you want, you may learn it into universities that there are different language of program. Now, as when you try to download LibreOffice and you couldn't download it because there is no program language in your computer installed that is Java or C++. There are different languages of computer. We call it Java, C++, the most common language used in a program. Follow the instruction. Now, as you can say, for example, I'm a teacher. I'm the one giving you instruction. I'm the one telling you, yeah, this is your project. You have to do the project like this. So who I am? I am the instructor. So whenever you want to create a program or anything, the first step is you must need to follow the instruction. If you see instructions, if you see in like our normal life, daily, everyday life, what the structure in our life for the simple task, sometimes we don't pay attention on the instruction to follow to get the things done. Like your mom said you something and you don't follow her, but you don't know what she said. So it's mean you lose the stuff, but you lose your task, or you cannot do your task more properly. So the instruction in your life are not always clear, and sometimes you have to decide by yourself what to do. For example, your mom wants to go somewhere. She just give you instruction. Yeah, you have to cook macaroni today. And yeah, this is instructions. Do like this, this, and that. You don't hear it properly. You forget it. Maybe some you don't write anywhere. So what you have to do? You have to think by yourself, decide by yourself, and you have to cook it. So computer cannot make the decision by themselves. So they have to follow very specific instruction. If you say computer, delete. For example, if I right click and I press delete, so only the computer will listen, because I'm the one giving instruction to computer to delete it, to cut it, to copy it, to paste it. By itself, computer don't know what they should supposed to do. Understand? Say yes or no.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. When I ask you understand, tell me if there is a question or no. Now, algorithm. Now, what is an algorithm? An algorithm is a step-by-step list of instructions that need to follow to solve a problem. You have a problem. You are out from your home and you lose. You don't know where is your home direction. Now what you should do? You need instruction, right? You need someone properly guide you that, yeah, Lamar, you need to go straight, then take the left from first exit, then take a U-turn. What is this all? Step-by-step instruction? We call this in a computer language. It's not in our life, but I'm talking about the computer language. We call it algorithm. Algorithm, step-by-step list of instruction that need to be followed to solve a problem. This instruction must be simple enough so that each step can be done without thinking about it. Like there is example of pizza bread. How can you make it? If you have a proper instruction, proper ingredients and the method, you can cook it by yourself easily, right? So what do you need? You need the proper instruction, even though the computer. If you just turn on the computer and you are just sitting and waiting, yes, the computer by itself make a PowerPoint presentation. No, it can't. You must give instruction. Same thing when you are creating any program, when you are creating a game program. So you need to put instruction at the back. What happened if the person die in the game? The game ends? Or either he can survive again. Do his have some life timelines or no? You see, every game have sometimes life timelines, sometimes surviving stuff. Someone can come and survive you. Yes or no?
Yes, teacher. Yes.
Yeah. So yes. These instructions are what? Created by a computer programmer, which is called algorithm. Algorithm comes from a word algorithmi, the Latin from the name of a famous Persian mathematician, Muhammad bin Musa al-Khwarizmi. He was the one who invented this name. It is a Latin name, and he worked in the math and geometry and astronomy, advanced the subject of algebra and trigonometry. He was the one, Muhammad bin Musa, the one who invented algorithm. Next thing is flowchart. Now flowchart, it is a design that represent or that tell an algorithm and show It is deep and the correct order. Show its steps and the correct order. This diagram, I will show you the diagram later, give a clear step-by-step procedure to solve a problem. The first step-by-step we do by algorithm, we write the steps. Second is a flowchart. Flowchart here, you write the steps on a drawing. What kind of drawing is it? This drawing helps you to describe your thought about how you can solve the problem with the computer before you actually write the program. This diagram, you will write it in your like piece of paper. And here's the example of diagram. There is one example and two examples. Let's see the first one. The problem is what? Lamp doesn't work. What you do? Lamp plug in. You need to check either the lamp plug in. If yes, then move to next step. If no, then go and plug in the lamp. If yes, then bulb burn out. Check if your bulb, light bulb, is burn out or is it correct. If it is yes, then replace the bulb. If it is no, then repair the lamp, the problem in lamp. Same thing, another example, you leave home. Okay, this is your, you are doing the instructions now. Leave home. Now next, check time. Check time, then you make decision. Before 7, yes, then take the bus. Before 7 p.m., no, then take subway, reach a school. Now each symbol in a flowchart have a meaning. So what is it? This thing, you must memorize it. Memorize means you must learn it, put it in your mind clearly. If the symbol is like that oval shape, we call it start and end. Any program, any instruction you want to start and end. Start what? Go to school, cook a dinner, clean my room. This is all your start symbol. Okay, and oval represent start or end point. When you're done, cleaning the kitchen. Kitchen is neat. Homework is finished. This arrow align in a correct that show relationship between the representative shape. From one step, if you go to the next step, we use the arrow line. Now, this parallelogram shape, it is your input and output, represents input and output. Or it can show the data, what you are entering, either input, like for example, input some chicken in a rice, what else input? Input, your input maybe can be rice, yogurt, like for example, if you are preparing a flowchart of your food, I'm talking the flowchart of your food. So first step, enter the kitchen or get the pot. Second arrow, draw the arrow, join it with parallelogram. Yeah, what do you need to do? You need to get the pot you need to put the yogurt, put the rice, put the chicken, whatever your inputs are. When you're done, now the process. The square rectangle means the process, the procedure. What the procedure is is going each time from one step to new step, you use the arrow. You use the arrow, move from one step to second step. This rectangle tells you that what is your process. You need to flame the heat high or low, whatever. Then the decision. Decision, the diamond indicate the decision. You have two options. Should I check or no? Or is it taste good or no? So let's suppose you say, is it taste good? You have two options, one arrow here, no and yes. The yes go to which step do you want to join it? Yes, if it is yes, then end. If it is no, then process again or go to input. Input, maybe you want to add something else, something more. The last is again your end symbol. Understand this point?
Yes.
Now, before you start designing any program, you must understand how to understand the problem you want. For example, let's say you want to calculate someone's age. Okay, first, what you have to think about the steps that you have to make to solve the problem. You need the current year and the year of birth. For example, how you can guess my age. I give you 2 seconds of chance and let's see who can guess my age. The year today is 2021. And I born in 1995. Now, who can calculate my age? When you want to get the age of some person, what you do? You have year of today and the year I born 1995. Raise your hand and let me see who can tell me my correct age. Whenever you want to get the age of someone, you subtract, yeah? You can see you need the current year and the year of a birth. Check the year of a birth is not larger than the current year. Subtract the birth from the current year. My birth year was 1995. Current year is 2021. 2021 minus 1995 give you my age.
Can I
okay, know?
Asma.
Farah.
Asma.
It's 26.
Okay, anyone else want to guess?
Teacher, I know.
Yes.
It's 26, yes.
It's 26, correct. It is after 2 months, it will be 26. So yeah, because it's 2021, so correct. So the same thing, what you do, you think, yeah, you are getting the age of some person, you just know the date of birth and the year you are now. So what you do, you subtract them. What is this thing? Subtraction is a procedure. Input was what? The year I born or the year current year today. And the decision that either you do the correct or wrong. Okay?
Okay.
Now, if you want to create any algorithm, you write down the small steps you need, like the same thing you do on the flowchart. Let's suppose you want to do that thing on your algorithm, like this one algorithm here. So you need to write the steps, yeah? So the first step, get the current year. Ask for the year of birth. Second step, check the year of birth is not larger than the current year, then subtract, then the result, then show to the person age. Now I want to give you like 5 minutes and I want you guys to draw the year of flowchart for me. Can you guys do it?
No, teacher.
Try to create a flow chart of the year, the same steps you. When you're done creating the chart, you can just show me and I'm here waiting for you. So only this is our lesson for today.